In Excel, it is possible to import data from a number of sources. One of these sources is a text file. Now you can do it in a number of ways, but probably the easiest, you can just open a file. As long as we've selected the files of type as all files, you'll be able to see all the other files. And for example, I'm going to pull through this file here, which is a text file called text example. When I click it and say open, you'll see Excel automatically goes to a text import wizard screen. This screen allows you to control how Excel is going to import the data. The first thing it needs to know is how is this data split up. You'll see the options are delimited, where character splits the information, or else fixed width, where for example the first column is 10 characters, the next column is 10 characters, etc. If you had to click delimited and you say next, what you'll see is Excel has put a tab and the data hasn't really changed. But we can see that actually commas are being used, so I'm going to switch that off and put commas. You'll see Excel immediately puts lines where all the commas appear, and you can scroll down to see if it makes sense. So if we go down here, you'll see the data seems to type. You can, if you have other characters that split the data, you can highlight them, even if it's an other, where you have to put in your own entry. If we go back, if we had chosen fixed width, and we go next, you'll see Excel tries to guess where the fixed widths are, but you can manually move these. So you can say, no, that's over there, and you can add a few more in if you want. So in this case, you actually have to tell Excel exactly where the split is. We're going to go back again. And in this case, we know it's delimited. So I'm going to go next. And we know it's a comma. So I'm happy with that. So I'm going to go next. Excel now gives you the opportunity to set the format of each column that you import. So for example, you'll see here that the first one, if we look at the data, looks like dates. So we can actually tell Excel, don't just bring it in as text, as you run the risk of Excel thinking the date is a text, and you're going to have to do work to get it into date format. You can actually say, okay, for this one, I want to make it a date. And you can be even more specific. You can specify what the format of the date is. So here you can see it's clearly day, month, year. So I can go to the day, month, year. However, if you have data that's perhaps month, day, year, you can then go to that one. Alternatively, for example, here we can use general or text. Or if you want, you can click on something there and say do not import. And basically it's going to just skip that one. There is also an advanced function. So if you click on it, you can specify how decimals are separated if it's not the standard way, and thousands as well. When we get to this situation, we're now in the position to say finished. And you'll see what Excel has done. It has brought all the data through. If we go a little bit lower down, you'll see where the key data is has been nicely split. And now that the data is in Excel, we can perhaps work on it to clean it up a little bit.